Hello students, we have seen the ladder diagram, ladder logics and instruction relays in program logic control part 1, and part 2 we are going to see about timers. In many control tasks there is a need to control time. For example, a motor or pump might need to be controlled to operate for a particular interval of time, or perhaps to be switched on after some time interval. PLCs thus have timers as built-in devices. Timers count fractions of seconds or seconds using the internal CPU clock considered. The common approach is consider timers to behave like relays with coils which are energized. It results in the closure of opening of contacts after some preset time. The timer is just treated as output for a run, with control being exercised over pairs of contacts elsewhere. Treatment of timer. Figure A shows a timer as an output for a run, with control being exercised over pairs of contacts elsewhere. Figure 2 shows the treatment of timer as a delay blocker, which is inserted in a run delay signal in the ring which reaches the output. Classification of timers. On delay timer, T on, T0, 0 to T, off delay timer, T off, and pulse timer, TP, which is shown in the figure. Generally, T-on timers are used in PLC. Timers which come on after a particular time delay is T-on. Timers which are on for a fixed period of time before turning off is T-off delay timer. And timer switches on or off for a fixed period of time is pulse timer. Sequencing by timers. When input 1 is on, output 1 is switched on. The contacts associated with the output can be stated in the timer. The contacts of timer will close after preset time delay 5.5 seconds. When this happens, output 2 is switched on. Thus, following the input 1, output 1 is switched on and followed 5.5 seconds later by output 2. This is called a sequence of outputs. Cascaded timers. Timers can be linked together. The term cascaded is used to give the longer delay timers than they are possibly with just one timer. Timer 1 with delay time of 999 seconds, the timer is started when there is an input of in 1. And 999 seconds time is up, the contacts of timer 1 close, then time starts 2 and delay of 100 seconds. When the time is up, timer 2 contact closes and output from out 1. Thus the output occurs as 1099 after completion of input 1. On-off cyclic timer. When there is an input 1 and the contact close, the delay for 5 seconds is set. On delay timers can be used to produce an on-off cycle timer. The timer is designed to switch an output for 5 seconds, then off for 5 seconds, then on for 5 seconds and off for 5 seconds and so on. This is a cyclic timer. Off delay timers. When momentarily input 1 and output 1 or timers are switched on, the input 1 is latched as output 1 contacts, the output remains on. After the preset timer delay, the timer contacts, which are normally closed, open and the switch off the output. Thus, the output stays on and remain on until the time delay has elapsed. Counters. Counters are provided as built-in elements in PLC and allow the number of occurrences of input signals to be counted. This might be where items have to be counted as they pass along a conveyor belt or a number of revolutions of a shaft, and perhaps the number of people passing through a door. Forms of counter. Down counters and up counters. Forms of representation of counters. Different PLC manufacturers deal with country slightly different ways. Some count down and some count up and reset and treat the counter as though it is a relay coil and so run the output. Basic counter programming. When there is a pulse input in 1, the counter is reset. When the input is 2, the counter starts counting and the counter set to say 10 pulses. 10 pulse input has been received and there is an output taken when the contact is closed. For example, consider a problem of a control of machine which is required to direct 6 tins along one path of packing in the box and 12 tins along another path of packing in another box. A deflector plate may be controlled by a photocell which gives an output every time a tin passes it. Thus, the number of pulses from the sensor has to be counted and used to control the deflector. When the pulse of input hits 400, both the counters are reset. Input which is counted might be an input from the photocell sensor, which detects the presence of tins passing along the conveyor. And Y30 might be the solenoid which is used to activate the deflector to deflect the items into one box or another. Shift registers. A group together of internal relays to form a shift register is done automatically, which is by a PLC which is selected. Example, a 4-bit shift register is represented in a ladder diagram as shown. We start by supplying momentary input in input. When input 1 is momentary, input 1 closes into the first relay. When we supply momentary input to input 2, it closes. And when another input is supplied into, the effect of the sequence in input 2 has been given to the sequence of the output 1, followed by output 2, followed by output 3, and followed by output 4. Master control relay. The alternative use of master control relay is the number of outputs which are controlled if sometimes necessary for the whole sections of the ladder to be turned on or off. Master control relay has with no input 1, and when input contacts are closed, there are two conditions as shown in the diagram. Jump condition. A function often provided with PLC is conditional jump, and if appropriate conditions are met, this function enables part of the ladder program to jump over. Jump instruction is denoted by CPJ control, conditional jump, and EJP end of jump. We can describe this as if some condition occurs, then perform some instruction, L perform some other instruction. Jump instruction is shown in the ladder diagram from input 1, rung 1, rung 2, rung 3, rung 4, and jump from 1 to 4. Data handling. The operations that may be carried out by PLC includes moving data, arithmetic operations, comparison and conversion. Data movement and data comparison for temperature alarm system and code conversion is shown in the diagram. Thank you.